In this section, I will be explaining about the OFDM modulation for terrestrial digital TV, that is the DVB-T modulation characteristic. So understand that in the last section, we have already covered about the modulation characteristics of digital video broadcasting with cable medium and satellite medium, and we have seen that what were its modulation characteristic. So the condition is going to be entirely different in the case of terrestrial transmission. We go for this type of OFDM modulation. So before directly going into these DVB-T characteristic, let us understand about the OFDM modulation. So OFDM modulation for terrestrial digital TV. Now OFDM, it is orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. So basically, what do you understand by the term frequency division multiplexing? We all know that multiple users can at a time, they can share a channel. That is, the users, they will be sharing a single link during the available bandwidth, but with different non-overlapping channels. That is, within available bandwidth, they all will be employing some non-overlapping sub-channels, and there may be guard bands, etc. That is the concept of frequency division multiplexing. Now, to this frequency division multiplexing, we add a concept of orthogonality carriers. That is what makes it OFDM modulation. Now, let us see the concept. So, OFDM, it is a multi-carrier wireless transmission system. Suppose that you have to transmit a signal over a bandwidth B, carrier frequency FC, when symbol time is 1 by B. So this is a frequency domain representation. So carrier frequency is FC, with symbol time here it is J1 microsecond. Now if it is given that the delay spread of the channel, we all know what is a delay spread. So if the delay spread of the channel, it is 2 microsecond, then what happens is that the combined symbol time, it will be 3 microsecond, which will reduce the efficiency. So you can see that the delay spread has occurred, and the channel efficiency, it is now being reduced. That is, the time, symbol time of is getting extended. That is what you mean by delay spread, and finally it may lead to the inter-symbol interference also. So if we are considering the 2 microsecond case, the delay spread, it is occupying some of the combined symbol time, and thus the efficiency of the channel is reduced, and the delay spread, it is difficult to control. And the effect of delay spread, it can be minimized only with the help of multiple carriers. Okay, so instead of using a single carrier of 1 megahertz, we can use, say, 100 subcarriers of 10 kilohertz. Then what happens? Each symbol, they will be having, say, a duration of 100 microsecond. Okay, so if it is having 100 microsecond duration, then a delay spread time of 2 microsecond, it will be having a negligible effect over the channel. So instead of having a single carrier, if we are able to use multiple subcarriers, okay, and this multiple subcarriers, each will be of lesser bandwidth. So if each of lesser bandwidth means it is getting the value of time, as in this example, it becomes 100 microsecond. So a delay time period of 2 microsecond, it is going to be negligible. That is, increases the channel efficiency. So that is the concept. So instead of having a single carrier with high bandwidth, use multiple subcarriers, okay, of lesser bandwidth, so that you can minimize the effect of delay spread and channel efficiency will increase. So this concept is used along with the FDMA. As you can see, these are the data signal. As the subcarriers, we have got now several subcarriers of lesser bandwidth. They are being modulated with data signals. They gain bandwidth centered around the subcarriers, and you can use guard bands also to separate them in frequency domain. Now, in the case of orthogonal frequency division multiple access, the users, they are provided with a set of subcarriers overlapping in frequency domain. So why it is overlapping? So usually we consider the guard bands, but in case of this type, we do not employ the guard bands also. Why is it so? Because the subcarriers are orthogonal, so it can occupy the same bandwidth without the interference. So no need of guard bands. The subcarriers can be closely packed, thus increasing the channel efficiency. So as you can see, usually in FDMA spectrum, we have to employ the guard bands. Okay, but in the case of OFDM, okay, we are having orthogonal carriers. So instead of using a single carrier, what did we do? We have used multiple carriers of reduced bandwidth and with the help of orthogonality maintained between the carriers, you can have no guard bands, so you can save the bandwidth. So this much bandwidth is saved. So closely spaced subcarriers of reduced bandwidth and without guard bands, that is the concept of OFDM spectrum. So how can you say the orthogonality of the carriers is maintained? That is, if you see this particular figure, you can have reference carriers and adjacent carriers. At the peak point of one wave, you can observe that the other two carriers, they are having the null position. Similarly, observe the green color. So at this particular peak point, the red, the blue and all the other color, they are having its null value. So this is how orthogonality between the carriers are maintained, and there is no need of guard band. So we have used multiple carriers with reduced bandwidth and without guard bands, and the orthogonality between the carriers is there. Okay, so it is going to give us a very much efficient technique. So this type of OFDM is used for DVB-T. So it produces overlapping spectra between the subcarriers. So the individual peaks of the subcarriers, it all will line up with the null of other subcarriers. So that is how orthogonality is there. It prevents the interference, and the relationship between the frequency of the lowest carrier and that of the carrier K is given by this particular relation. The frequency spectrum of such set of carriers shows secondary parasitic lobes of width 1 by TS, that is TS is a simple time period. So sometimes in the case of real condition, signals may be coming from indirect path, it will add to direct path and the orthogonality may not be maintained, and it may result in inter-symbol interference. So it becomes necessary to add a small guard interval which occupies only a less time of TS by 4. Okay, so we get the new symbol period as delta plus TS, that is we add a small guard interval. And this for terrestrial digital television, the DVB technical module, it has retained OFDM modulation with 2K carriers or 8K carriers, for which the spectrum can be considered as virtually rectangle. That is, in the case of residential digital terrestrial television, digital video broadcasting technique, we use a modulation of OFDM, orthogonal frequency division multiplexing technique. And usually the values which we choose is either 2K carriers or this 8K carriers. So we are having multiple carriers here and orthogonality is maintained. And if you are observing the spectrum, okay, this is a power spectral density in the y-axis, that is how much power is contained in these relative frequency, and these are the frequency relative to the central frequency. So if you are observing the spectrum, this is how the spectrum is, it will be virtually rectangle. That is, we can say that the main lobe of the power spectral density of each and every carrier, if you are observing, it is very much narrower than twice the carrier spacing, okay, twice the carrier frequency spacing. And if you observe in a particular frequency range, we can observe that the spectral density is not constant. And in over a particular range, it is approximately seen as virtually rectangular type. So this is a experimental plot obtained. And these are some of the features of DVB-T. So it has got three modulation options. So there is a balance between the amount rate at which the data can be transmitted. So with the help of the COFDM in DVB-T, further you can do the modulation. Any of the options, higher order modulations you can choose. For example, the lower order modulation format do not transmit data as fast as 64 QAM. So depending upon the requirement of the operator, we can choose the modulation then. Then we can have 5 different forward error correction rate, that is 1 by 2, 2 by 3. So this means that for transmitting 1, we are sending out 2 bits, 1 used for error correction. Then for 2, we are sending 3 bits. Again, that is for error correction process. So likewise, we can have different forward error correction rates. So depending upon the need of the broadcasting network, we can use the convolutional coding or Reed-Solomon coding with certain rates. Okay, then we'll be having the 2K or the 8K carriers, as I told. So the actual number of carriers used is also given. This is standard for the OFDM technique. and the channel bandwidth, it can be of either 6, 7 or 8 megahertz. It is compatible with all existing TV channelization system, and the video refresh rate can be either at 50 or 60 hertz. Okay, so these are the characteristic features of the DVB-T. And this is how the channel coding and modulation is performed for DVB-T. So we know once source coding has been performed, we have to do the channel coding, that is read Solomon, interleaving, then inner coding, that is Viterbi encoding, etc. has to be done, convolutional coding. So all these are channel coding. And in the case of DVB-T, additionally, we have to perform a internal interleaving. Okay, that is for further the reducing of the burst errors. We do the process of interleaving also. That is an effective coding method for dispersion of the bit errors. So for further security, again we have to perform this internal interleaving. It will change the adjacent relationship between the bits. That is most effective method for dispersing the bit errors. Then we are forming the OFDM symbols and constituting a frame. Then we do the OFDM modulation and finally the guard interval insertion. So these are the steps involved in the channel coding and modulation of DVB-T. So first you can say that after the channel coding process, we perform a interleaving process at the bit level, which forms the matrices of 126 words. And we can choose, depending upon our modulation, we can choose a number of bits. And then we group it and form the symbols. In case of 2K mode, that is if you are choosing 2K carriers, we group it by 12. And in case of 8K mode, we group it by 48. And then we constitute a frame, that is 68 symbols constitute a frame. And 4 frames, a super frame it forms. And then finally, OFDM modulation. And the carriers, we have multiple carriers. They are not individually modulated, but modulated with the help of this inverse FFT, which will transform the input data to time domain to frequency domain. So this type of this modulation which we are using for this DVB-T, we code it as a coded orthogonal frequency division multiplexing technique. It is followed in a digital terrestrial TV receiver. So these are the steps which is employed in channel coding and modulation of DVB-T. So it is basically a coded orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. That is, once a channel coding is being performed, again we will do a complex interleaving process for further protection of the errors. And then after grouping of the symbols and forming the frame, we go for the OFDM modulation and we convert it into frequency domain. So these steps are also performed. So this is a reason why when we look at the front end of the DVB-T reception system, the front end is more complicated when we are comparing with the DVB-C or DVB-S, because of all these processes has to take place in OFDM modulation. Okay, so these are the things which we have to study about OFDM. So first of all, why is there, what is the significance of OFDM? So instead of one carrier, we are going to use multiple carriers of reduced bandwidth. And since the orthogonality of carriers, if it is maintained, even there is no requirement of the guard bands, and we can save our bandwidth to a large extent. So this, along with the frequency division multiplexing, we add the orthogonality of carriers, and this is a technique. See, OFDM is a technique which we are used for terrestrial digital video broadcasting. And after performing the source coding and the channel coding, again there are some steps prior to the OFDM modulation. We do interleaving process and constituting a frame, symbol forming, etc. We finally do this OFDM. So it is basically called as a coded orthogonal frequency division multiplexing technique. This is followed in the case of digital terrestrial TV receiver. So remember, at the conclusion stage, the modulation characteristic which we are employing for DVB, digital video broadcasting cable, it is going to be 64 quadrature amplitude modulation, 64 QAM we are employing. For satellite, we are employing the QPSK, quadrature phase shift keying. And in the case of DVB-T, we go for this COFDM technique.